Welcome to the fourth and final segment of the SLIS 701 Introduction to Library and Information Studies module on Technology and Library Information Science. In parts 2 and 3 of this module, I explored a virtual library environment with library staff on the ground at Queens Library in New York. Calvin Watson, Chief Innovation and Technology Officer, and Manuel Figueroa, Talent Development and Training Manager, shared their experiences with developing mobile discovery and delivery platforms, as well as in-house staff instruction, elements crucial to the implementation of the virtual library at Queens Library. In this segment, I will highlight current and future technology trends in library information science. The learning objectives for this segment are to identify and discuss current and future technological trends in library and information science. We are at the dawning of the age of Web 3.0, but most libraries today use Web 2.0 technologies to extend access and expand services to library members. Librarians rely on a host of digital and mobile technology in a variety of ways, from aggregation services to compile data from unrelated sources, GPS navigation apps to locate materials in the library, and mobile apps for providing access to resources for self-directed learners. The social web of libraries and library members is practically boundless. It includes presentation tools, content management systems, shareable data sets, podcasts, YouTube channels, data visualizations, mashups, folksonomy tags. Frankly, it could be overwhelming, and it's not realistically possible to stay on top of every technological advance, mobile application, or web service versioning that is transmitted over the internet. Thankfully, libraries and other information and cultural organizations or agencies convene thought leaders to share information on technological trends, advances, forecast, and report back with free and open access documents. The New Medium Consortium Horizon Reports are the culmination of a series of ongoing dialogues focused on the exploration and use of new media technologies by a panel of educators, entrepreneurs, information and culture professionals, and technologists. The reports highlight the short, mid, and long-term impact of technological trends and challenges in library, museum, K-12 and higher education sectors. The NMC Horizon Report 2015 Library Edition was formed by a panel of 53 participants representing 15 countries on 5 continents. The consensus among the panel was that there were 2 predominant themes that technology trends and challenges centered around: open access models in research, and the use of library space for hands-on activities and training. Libraries are transformed by technology through the means of policy, leadership, and practice. The direction that a technology takes has policy implications because policies are the laws, regulations, rules, and guidelines by which libraries are governed. Leadership confers the vision and direction of a trend, and practice is the setting in which actionable ideas and services take place. Some of the topics that consistently emerged around technological decision-making and planning concerned open access to peer-reviewed articles, the need for policies guiding the storage, publication, and dissemination of digital content and emerging formats, leadership around managing and enhancing discovery tools that ensure engaging mobile experiences, moving large print collections to off-site storage centers, and reconfiguring library spaces to flexible active learning spaces, and access and preservation of digital content combined with training and digital curation. Trends accelerating technological adoption in libraries include the increasing accessibility of research content, the evolving nature of the scholarly record, increasing focus on research data management, the increasing value of the user experience, and prioritization of mobile content and delivery. As the cost of collections and data management continues to rise, librarians are focused on finding or creating cost-effective means to increase access to scholarly materials. Open access publishing has emerged as a viable solution. There are two types of open access publishing. Green access, a process of self-archiving through the submission of content to a free repository, and gold access, which requires an article processing fee funded by subsidy support from a university or government body, or an author paying out of pocket. The evolution of the scholarly record is being driven by the move from the printed record to the digital, and the shift from text-based materials to research data sets. The process of scholarly publishing is also being accomplished through digital means, what has been called a web of objects. Certification has been performed online using the open peer review platform PubPeer. Articles published using a digital object identifier, and papers distributed through archive. Challenges impeding technological adoption include embedding academic and research libraries in core curricula, improving digital literacy, competition from alternative avenues of discovery, rethinking the role and skills of librarians, embracing the need for radical change, and managing knowledge obsolescence. There is a need for sustained information literacy training as librarians are increasingly expected to help library members gain familiarity and skills with the latest research tools and practices. This requires greater involvement as an instructor. Digital media offers opportunities to interact with subject matters in new ways, and instructors need support developing assignments that take advantage of new formats. However, there is a mismatch between the skills required to develop integrated instructional programs and the knowledge and training librarians receive. To compensate for this gap, librarians must rely on leadership communities to establish standards. The Horizon Project Library Panel believed that the issue is solvable through embedding information literacy into the core curriculum. The Horizon Project Library Panel also identified 7 technologies they expect to drive technology planning and decision making. Consumer technologies, which are tools created for recreational and professional purposes that are adapted into educational use and find their way into libraries. Digital strategies are ways of using devices and software to enrich teaching, learning, research, and information management. Enabling technologies transform the expectation of devices and tools by expanding the reach of a tool and making it more capable, useful, and often easier to use. Internet technologies include techniques and essential infrastructure to help make underlying network technologies more transparent and easier to use. Learning technologies developed expressly for learning and include tools adapted for other purposes to form strategies that make them useful for learning. Social media technologies. Visualization technologies are tools and processes for mining large data sets, exploring dynamic processes, and making the complex simple. The Horizon Project Library panel highlighted six technologies they agreed have the potential to foster real changes in research, information management, content delivery, and learning. The six technologies were makerspaces, online learning, information visualization, semantic web and linked data, location intelligence, and machine learning. Librarianship involves a combination of organizational, administrative, interpersonal, and technical skills. Librarians are increasingly expected to be proficient in using and implementing new technologies. But not all practitioners are technologists. Some are challenged by the dynamic nature of technological change. If you find that you're not comfortable with using certain technologies, try strengthening your tech skills by enrolling in some of the SLIS courses like Introduction to Information Technologies, Online Information Services, Information Technology in the School Library Program, Design and Management of Databases, Web Technologies for Information Specialist, Design and Management of Digital Image Collections, and Information Networks. Also, try taking some self-paced online courses through Lynda or Treehouse, or following Manuel Figueroa's suggestion to look for YouTube tutorials. Finally, it's important that you are mindful of the digital divide. Don't assume library members have access to the internet, have a computer, or computer skills. Thank you for your time and attention.